Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today's video, we're gonna be doing something really quick with my home automation system. I'm gonna be setting up an actual alarm for my lift station over here for the pump. So if it ever fails, it notifies my phone. In addition, I'm gonna put an energy monitor on here to monitor and track how much energy this thing uses and how often it runs. So stay tuned. So over here, I've got this E1 sewer systems alarm panel for my septic pump or my lift station pump back here. One of the things is this thing, whenever it alarms, I don't know if it alarms or not, and I don't know how often it runs. So today I'm gonna be putting in a Wi-Fi energy monitor. That way it notifies my phone if the alarm ever goes off. And also I can track the energy usage and how often this thing runs. So this thing is an E1 environmental one system. They're one of the few companies that make these grinder pumps and these lift station pumps for your house. So a lot of people are kind of stuck with this thing, and as these things age, they start to fail, and these alarms are usually on the outside of the house, so you never know if they're on or not until maybe it's too late. So we'll go ahead and put this alarm on today. So for this particular one, it's a 240 volt system. So I've got 240 volts on here, but inside the panel, they actually divide it out and they pull a 120 circuit right here for the actual alarm panel. We're gonna be pulling power off the 120 side of this to use to power that new system. We use the 240 because those things are universal all the way up to 250 volts. I'm gonna take this dry contact right here. There's a dry contact on the board right here that closes whenever the alarm goes off. So I'm gonna use that to actually notify me when the alarm goes off, and then I'm gonna put the CTs on the red and the black right here to know when the pumps are actually running. So go ahead and do this alarm monitoring and also the circuit and power monitoring. I decided to pick up some of these Wi-Fi parts. These are pretty much generic Chinese stuff that uses the Tuya app or the Smart Life app. That they're both basically the same company, but these products are all compatible with it. These things right here, this is just a dry contact switch circuit. The only thing I'm gonna be using on this is the dry contact to know when it's on and off. It's gonna get the line in, but I'm not gonna have any line out. So all I'm using this for is an indicator through SmartThings. Over here, this is the CT circuit. So this is actually gonna be measuring both legs of my 240 volt single phase on the pump. And I'm gonna go ahead and put that into here on circuit 1 and 2. And it takes a line and a neutral right here for the main power, which is gonna be 120 volts or even up to 240 volts, depending on what you have available. But we're gonna go ahead and just use these to do the monitoring circuit. The first thing I need to do is actually pair this up to the app. So we'll go ahead and do that today on the bench since we're close to the Wi-Fi source. So both of these are actually compatible from 100 volts up to 250. So it's got a broad range as far as the input goes for the power. So you could go ahead and just use whatever source you have in your cabinet. If you have only 240, you could use that. Or if you have 120, you could use that too. But to set up today, we're just gonna plug up a 120 right here to the outlet and just plug it into the wall. So I plugged up the wire right here to my other wire that I'm gonna end up plugging up there. So neutral is white and line is black, if you guys didn't know. So that's pretty much set up. After that, you just wanna download the app. I'm gonna use the Tuya app today to do this, but you could also do the Smart Life app, and it goes through the whole process. Basically, once you open the app, you scan it. You scan the QR code here, and then you pretty much follow all the directions here to get it synced up to the app. All right, so we'll go ahead, plug this baby in, and then go to the app. I'm gonna add device. And we're just gonna go through everything. It's gonna request permissions and then just use while I'm on the app. And then it's discovering devices. So I wanna go add. So right now the device is already seeing that device right now, and it's adding the Wi-Fi password to it so it can actually talk. It gave me an error on the 5 GHz network. So I actually went back in and put the regular 2.4 GHz. So it's trying to add it right now. Looks like successful, so we're done with that one. So I'm gonna go ahead and add the other one now. So here's pretty much the interface for it. It shows you the kilowatt hours right there, the generation, if you're monitoring your solar. And then we got two circuits on here, so it does two independent circuits if you wanted to. Or I think on mine with the 240, I could put it on both legs of it to get the full 240 volt and then figure out that. But yeah, we can watch it live if we had it connected, and we could watch the usage, and over time we could probably just monitor it and just keep the rolling total or the history of it. So that's pretty good, just to on any kind of circuit that you're setting up, to monitor the energy consumption of it. So again, once we plug that new one in, or that fresh one that we just set up, it starts blinking red on the actual device, and then we'll go back into the app and go ahead and just hit the plus button on the top just to add another device. And it already sees it, so we just go ahead and add, and then we want to go ahead and just select. So we want to select the same wireless network and password. It's going to go ahead and just start loading it. It gets a little finicky the first time. I had to do it twice, but it finally added. So we're done with this one. And then it's going to set up. It takes a few minutes to do the setup screen right here. And we'll get to the interface. But yep, right there. So you can hear it when I clicks on and off as I do this. So that works. One other thing I want to test too is the dry contact on here. So I'm gonna go ahead and get a jumper and see how the dry contact works. So for the dry contact, all it really needs is an open and close. That's what the whole point of a dry contact is. It doesn't need any voltage or anything. So we pretty much get a jumper and put it onto it, and it switches on and off. So when we have our alarm on this setup, I'm just gonna have it in SmartThings to monitor this. Anytime that switch comes on and it turns this device on, it's gonna give me a text and a warning that I have an alarm on my panel out there and to address it. But yeah, these devices are pretty common now all over Amazon. They're like between $7 to $10 each. And they work really well if you don't overload them. I see a lot of people commenting or leaving reviews about these things burning out on them. And it's because they're trying to run like motor loads off of them. If you look at this thing, it's pretty tiny, and I just don't imagine the relay in there holding that much amperage through it. So you can't really hold a motor and pass all the current through a motor on here, but you could turn on a light bulb, you could turn on a ceiling fan, things like that pretty easily. And the beauty of this is you can install it like inside a device, inside a ceiling fan, or at a light, because a lot of times a lot of people with older homes don't have a neutral in their switch box and they can't use that. So you can use this as an alternative and control it from your phone, Alexa, Google, or Siri, and HomeKit. So that's pretty good with this thing. It is HomeKit enabled if you have a HomeKit. So for a wiring setup, I'm just gonna basically just jumper it from one side to the next here, and then connect that out to the actual box where we're gonna pull the 120 volt out there. But while we're on the bench, I'm gonna go ahead and just make these connections here, and then that way when I get out there, it makes it easier to put it, mount it, and all that, and wire it up. So I created this little thing right here. It's like a little jumper with the wires coming over, and then I double tapped it over here out. It is kind of tight, especially with this 14 gauge wire, which is right for the 15 amp circuit I'm gonna hook this onto. You could use thinner wire, but I wouldn't recommend it for this application just because. But anyway, so we'll go ahead, try this out and see how it works. The other way you can do it is have wires coming out of here and just have wire nuts onto a pigtail and then connect it onto the actual thing, but I wanted to make it look nice. So I'm actually gonna mount this thing inside the cabinet right here, snap this guy in, and then kind of just hold it up with the wire right here in this setup. I'm gonna go ahead and put a wire here for the dry contact. I could just use a regular low voltage for that one. So that bracket that came with didn't fit back here and fit everything well, so I just ended up 3M double siding a tape right here onto the side. So I'm gonna go ahead and make that connection right here to the dry contact, and then the power connections, and we should be good on this. So I ended up connecting that dry contact right here to the board. I connected the neutral to the common neutral right here on the board, and then I double tapped this derail breaker right here for the 120 volt. So we should be good on that. I'm gonna go ahead and put the CTs on, plug them up or put them on here, and we should be good on this. So for the CTs, all they do is just clip onto here and they pivot. So you do is just put it right around the wire, clip it on, and that's pretty much it. That's what you need to do right there. So it would just kind of hang out right here. on the thing, and then you plug up the input into the one and the two right here. I'm not sure which one's positive or negative. I gotta check out, but I assume the black is gonna be negative, so it's gonna be the negative on there, and then the yellow is gonna be the positive. Another thing to keep in mind too is the direction of current flow. So if you know which way your power is going towards the device, you gotta make sure you have that directional arrow that way. So I made all the connections. I did a little loop-de-loop to kind of hang these circuit transformers right there. Plugged everything up. So we'll go ahead, pull the breaker inside, turn this all back on and see if it communicates. So plugged it up, just waiting for it to find its Wi-Fi signal. As you can see, it's still blinking red right there. The alarm on the backside, it found that one. So we just gotta wait for this guy to get its Wi-Fi signal. So I finally got everything to connect to the Wi-Fi and reconnect and everything and double checked. And I ran it, and as you can see on there, it shows a negative kilowatt hour on the first test try. As you can see, this arrow right here is not accurate, so we had to flip it back around to actually show the positive KW or energy use. The one thing I'm wondering why the arrow goes that way, maybe it's thinking it's on the generation side, or maybe they use negative as the consumption versus generation, I don't know, but I'm gonna flip it around just to know that the KW is positive. So we flipped it back around, I'm gonna go ahead and run this and see what the KW and everything shows up. As you can see, both circuits are equal, so you basically have to add them together since this is a single phase 240 and we're measuring each leg. I'll go ahead and button everything up and set this up in SmartThings and set my alarms and everything. Hey guys, thanks for joining me on this quick video on doing this energy meter and alarm on here using that Wi-Fi stuff that I got on Amazon. So I'm gonna integrate this all to SmartThings. Even though it's on its own app, they have a SmartThings integration. I'm gonna use it all over in SmartThings. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you guys haven't subscribed to my channel to stay on top of all my different DIY content, whether it's on the house, on the car, in the garage, or whatever I'm doing, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.